Berg Chilling Systems is a Toronto-based private company that makes a mechanical refrigeration system. Now, this system can be used to compress and recover natural gas liquids at oil well sites that would otherwise, in many cases, just be burned off. Our guest says that this refrigeration system can help meet climate targets in North America. We're joined by Don Berggren. He's president of Berg Chilling Solutions. It's great to see you.
Thank you, Andrew. Pleased to be here.
And it's a family-owned company, I guess.
It is, yes.
Right. So tell us what your technology... We know that North Dakota, for example, they just burn a lot of the natural gas, wasting it, creating pollution. How does your technology work then?
Well, we're trying to help those oil producers reduce that burning. We take that gas stream, capture it, compress it, and then cool the gas down, down to about minus 40 degrees. In that process, we're liquefying the heavy carbons, the C3 pluses.
Those are the valuable natural gas liquids?
For sure. That would include things like propane and butane and hexane. We capture those and they can be trucked off-site. The dry residue gas can then be used for power generation on-site to reduce the operator's dependence on diesel. It can be compressed. It can be liquefied for LNG processes. So it actually, all that methane could be diverted from the atmosphere.
And your specialty is refrigeration of all kinds and chilling?
Absolutely. Our end of the business is the refrigeration side, yes.
So what are you adding to the mix here?
Well, our component is really the heart of the G2IT system. G2IT is a client partner of ours.
Based in Montana.
Billings, Montana, yes. So the refrigeration part of their technology is the largest part, and it does the majority of the work.
So the say again, yours is the core of the system, the refrigeration.
Correct, yes, yes.
And so one of the big things here, you note that oil wells at first spurt out product.
Yes.
You need a lot of chilling, but then they begin to wind down, especially, I think, these shale wells.
Absolutely.
And so the advantage is you can just add and take away units?
Correct. That's one of the nice things about the technology. They're designed in scalable sizes, shipped to the site on tractor trailer beds, and within a day we can be adding or taking away units to maximize the operation.
Have you found the oil industry receptive, or is their attitude, we got enough on our plate right now?
Actually, they are receptive. I think they all want to be green operators, and they want to be good stewards of the environment. And we're pleased to provide them with a technology that really works to achieve those goals.
So are you mostly in the States right now with this technology?
Currently, our client partner, G2IT, is out of Billings, Montana. So
yep.
Our focus has been in North Dakota and Montana. But we think we're ready to be helping operators here in Canada as well.
Have they been receptive?
Starting to be, yes.
You seem to be. I mean, it's a conservative industry in some ways, I guess.
It absolutely is, and it takes time. The advantage we have coming into the Canadian market is that we do have a proven solution. Mm-hmm. We can point to 30 operations in the States. Mm-hmm. Over the last 3 years, we've captured 23 million gallons of natural gas liquids, diverted 5 billion standard cubic feet of flare gas, and eliminated almost 200,000 tons of CO2 from the atmosphere.
Is this flaring? I mean, it can be unpleasant for local residents.
Absolutely. And I'm sure they'd be pleased that there's a solution to help with that.
Because, I mean, if they want to start fracking in Britain and stuff, they're going to, you know, those suburbs very near, they're going to need to clean the stuff up.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and there's really no reason for flaring unless it's an upset condition. If some of the equipment fails in any way, then, of course, you have to have a flare. But under normal operation, we can collect it and move it off-site.
How much of your business now, of the overall business, would you say is oil and gas? How much of your revenue?
Well, when oil prices were higher, it was certainly a lot more than it is now. But we see it as a growth market, and we want to be a part of this market.
Are you Have you and other manufacturers, so many manufacturers have closed in Ontario, southern Ontario. Driving around, you see empty factories. You've managed to hang on despite the high currency, but you've had to adapt.
We're very fortunate. We're very diversified. We supply cooling solutions to a very wide range of industries, from plastics to automotive to petrochemical to food and beverage, recreational ice. So we have a very broad industry base, and as one industry is doing better, we tend to focus there, as waiting for the other ones to catch up.
I guess the world is your oyster. The world is your lobster, as a friend of mine used to say, because Nigeria, they flare incredible amounts of gas there.
Tremendous. And there's almost every oil field that we see, there's opportunity.
Yeah, the Middle East, and yeah.
And we are actively marketing in the Middle East as we speak.
We will be watching closely. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
Our guest has been Don Berggren. He's president of Berg Chilling Systems.